Does religion affect the kind of music that you listen to, or does it not?
Very much so.
In what way?
Lyrics that are offensive to my beliefs as a Catholic, I choose not to listen to.
Is it curse words, or is it certain topics also?
Well, curse words, but I mean, I'm not totally offended by curse words.
Religion affects music just as much as, like, culture affects music.
Are you religious?
Spiritual, more spiritual than religious.
Ooh, that's that new wave stuff.
Not necessarily. In college, I took a course on religions of the world, and I think that I take different aspects from different religions and apply them to my life. Ultimately, it all ends in being a good person, right?
Your good ain't gonna get you there. You gotta be born again. You gotta ask me to forgive you of your sins, because he's the only one can wash away sins and no one else can. And that's why I came to him. Because I didn't know that I thought when I died I was just gonna go to heaven, but he said not so. I had to be born again to get into the kingdom of God.
I pray all the time. And just because I don't go to church doesn't mean, like, I'm a bad person.
What's your opinion on religion and music?
There is no God. That's my opinion on religion. So maybe there is no music.
What is a song that you think the devil is playing on his playlist right now?
The rap.
Yeah.
And when they sing rap songs, they talk about filthy stuff. They talk about how women are. They curse. They do all kind of nasty things. And some of the rap music and the pictures that they show, the women's taking off their clothes, showing their
bodies. Is Little Kim a minion of the devil?
Little Kim. I don't know too much.
What about Nicki Minaj?
All of them, I think all of them is just bad because God don't like it.
I think topics like abortion, things like that, and also just lyrics that really degrade women.
Do you believe in God?
You never know till you try.
I'm American, but my parents are from Jamaica, both mother and father. And me personally, I don't believe in religion because there's so many religion, but I do believe in a higher being, such as i.e. God. But to me, I think there's so many religions that it basically cancel each other out as far as which to believe and which not to. So I just choose not to believe in no religion whatsoever.
Some people just unfortunately haven't been brought up to understand who God is. So because of that, they have issues, you know, evolving. So I think as time goes on and God is more accepting to people, they will actually go out and seek information. It's just about information, going to get the information you need, and then you can determine what to believe in and what not.
When you say there is no God, are you just talking about all the other ones but our God?
No.
So there's like no God?
No God.
Like, so when we die, we don't like go to heaven?
No.
So then all of that music that Whitney Houston sang before she became a pop sensation was a waste of her time?
No, it was really fun.
The voice that God has gave Whitney Houston, he gave it to her to sing for the glory of God. If she would have came back to God and repented of her sins and asked God to put his Holy Spirit back inside of her, all the things that she would have went through, she wouldn't have went through, because God has the power to took her from all of that. Because the Bible said, what can a man gain the whole world and lose his soul? Whitney Houston had many, 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 many chances, and he gave her a lot of time to get it right with him.
So, like, what's heaven for you then?
There is none.
If you stub your toe and you're like, oh, God, what does that mean?
That's a colloquialism.
Do you ever say that?
Yeah.
But you're just, you're acknowledging that it's useless?
No.
Then are you saying that there is no religion, but it's not useless to use the terminology or to have an understanding of its background?
No, I think that religion is really helpful for some people who need something stable in their lives.
Like crackheads.
Right.
And born-again Christians.
Yeah, sure.
As a born-again Christian, I'm sure you listen to a lot of gospel and stuff. Are there any other types of music that you listen to?
The only music I listen to is only the gospel, because the gospel can only make me think about all the goodness that God has done for me, and my mind can be on him to thank him and give him all the glory for all the things he done. The other music can't make me think that way. The other music make me think about my past and things I've done. I'd rather dance for Jesus Christ. I'd rather dance for God, the glory of God. All this dancing and stuff out here is nothing. I mean, what is it doing for people? It's not doing anything for anybody. Yeah.
Do Native Americans believe in God?
They believe in all sorts of gods. They've been sort of a polytheistic culture for, you know, long, long time. And it ranges from tribe to tribe as well.
Being a Trinidadian, do you think of also, like, Jesus Christ and God?
No, well, because our main festival is Carnival, and it's against the religion to celebrate Carnival, so as a Trinidadian, I don't really consider my religion part of me.
Do you listen to gospel music?
Yes, I'm Muslim, but I love gospel music.
She's actually a Christian right here. Do you think that there are a lot of similarities between the two religions?
Actually, it's a lot of similarities. They all preach peace and love and unity and the oneness of God.
Do you think that there's a possibility of you ever becoming a born-again Christian?
No. No possibility whatsoever.